Bruce just, he and I in my room, he's just laying there purring, being a sweet angel.
You have scars all over you of him being so sweet.
Ow, 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 ow!
He just bit me on the eye, and it hurts.
The worst attack was about 2 weeks ago. It was like a rattlesnake biting me. He drew lots of blood. And now I'm really scared of him. But the worst behavior out of him is the peeing.
Mico has pretty much peed everywhere in this house.
Woke up this morning with pee next to my foot.
Mico basically has been quarantined to her room.
My room smells like a litter box.
It certainly does.
Mico, dang it.
You and I fight pretty often about this cat.
It's very stressful to come home to that.
It's very stressful living in that. Honestly, when she goes off to college, we are going to have to talk about rehoming him.
Tell me about Mico.
He's peeing everywhere. He's attacking
everybody. He seems very unhappy and aggressive.
I can't sit here for more than 30 seconds without seeing that gash on the side of your neck there.
This is a scratch from his back claw.
Is that something that happens a lot?
Yes. For his first year, he was a very happy cat. Anybody could play with him. He was really close to our Chihuahua, Tiffany. And then she passed away, and then that's when everything changed.
The day that she passed away is when the peeing started. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Animals grieve as profoundly and deeply as humans do, and we got proof right here.
Usually we try to corral him just to stay in my room.
Is it fair to say that at this point he's living in your room for the most part?
Yes. Yeah. And he's peed on me before I was sleeping.
What?
Yes.
Peed on you while you were sleeping?
Yeah.
Really? So now it's time to spend some time with Mr. Mico. Gina, I'm gonna give you a break, all right? See you in a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm more than a little trepidatious because Mico is known to lash out at his only ally, Alex. So what's he gonna do to me?
Hi, buddy. Hi. Yeah.
I'll move over this way a little bit. Man, he is one tense cat. You see how he doesn't change that position?
Mm-hmm.
He's frozen. His senses are frozen. His anxiety level is so high, he is in a constant state of territorial panic.
Yeah.
That's why he is swiping at people, biting them, peeing all over the place the way he does. If I were in this room alone with him right now, all I would be getting would be heightened, crazy aggression. Your presence here provides grounding.
Yeah.
If you don't mind, go to the other side of the bed, okay? I just want to see what he does when he's with me.
Okay.
Clearly anxious. Come here, buddy. Come here. Oh. It's okay, buddy. It's okay. Now, Mico didn't attack me, but he didn't calm down either. But what that does tell me is that he's not a violent cat by nature. I want you to do something that has nothing to do with Mico. It's
okay.
About releasing the energy around what has happened to him. It's about letting go of old energy. And part of that is Tiffany. And I want you to create something. Put your heads together on that one. I'm not going to give you any more direction other than that. I wanted to give Alex and Gina something to do together to honor the memory of Tiffany so that we can get all this negative energy behind us and concentrate on making Mico a better cat. I'll see you soon.
Thank you.
Why, hello.
Hi.
Guys, tell me how it's going. Any pee whatsoever?
I think maybe one time, which is really good. Since we started him on some meds, we saw improvements, which gave me hope.
That is so fantastic.
Woo, we're home free.
We're home free.
I'm really happy that Mico hasn't peed on anything.
We couldn't be happier.
You got the meds from the doctor?
We saw the drastic change in Mico almost immediately.
You're right.
Yeah.
Now, they tell me they went to the vet, and just as I suspected, the vet said that Mico would benefit from being on mood-stabilizing medication. Now, Mico appears to be a cat that suffers from a chemical imbalance. The meds are working, which in turn helps him to no longer pee inappropriately. Knock, knock.
Hey, Jackson.
Hey, guys.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm good.
Hi.
How are you?
Come on in.
The space. Okay. So, if there are people here, she's never just lounging out in the open. Is that right?
Very rarely.
Yeah.
Okay.
And someone comes to the door and they come in,
she's aggressive.
So that's her saying that as long as there's other people in my territory, I feel completely threatened. Mm-hmm. Already, I feel like there's a goal, right?
Oh, good.
Can we have her right here, not under, but right in the middle of the room, taking in? If we can get Simone comfortable in the middle of the room, she'll feel like she owns the space. And if she feels like she owns the space, by having a territory to call her own, she'll be less aggressive. Where is Simone?
Locked in the bedroom.
Of course she is. All right, Kelly, I'm gonna grab you because we got an experiment to do. Let's go meet Simone.
Okay.
All right.
Come on.
Okay, great.
When Kelly laughs or cries, Simone attacks her. Well, I figure it's time to find out more about that. I took Kelly with me. I had to see that for myself. So it happens a lot in here, right?
It's happened only in here.
Okay, so what I'm gonna have you do is, it's gonna feel really weird, but
yes.
Get into bed.
Okay.
And show me, you're just watching TV usually.
Watching TV.
So start crying or laughing or whatever it is, okay?
I knew that it was something we had to do just to see if Jackson could help her. I know that she's about to attack. It was uncomfortable.
Okay, sorry. Wow.
Yeah.
I don't even know what to say. 20 years I've been doing this and I've never, not one time, heard of this happening before. That's crazy.
I know.
Simone just turned around, marched right at her, and in the middle of this, boom, she got her. I mean, she just went right at her. That was one of the strangest things I've seen. It was time to let Kelly leave the room and let me have some time with Simone, which I gotta tell you, a little nervous. Simone, I'm just gonna sit here.
I think Jackson's gonna feel the same wrath as everybody else.
Now, let's do something real weird here. Ow! Ow! Oh my God, you're so weird. You're making me cry. Okay. Ow. Okay. Listen. We don't have to do this. I can tell by the fact that Simone has backed herself into a corner that she's feeling territorially threatened. She's saying, stay away, and believe me, she's sending a message loud and clear. But she also attacks when she detects a high level of emotion, and that could be directed at anyone, even Kelly and Pete. I gotta give these guys some homework. The first thing I got here is your sensory cat pack.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, in the sensory cat pack here, I've got all kinds of toys. Getting her energy out and owning the territory in the middle of the room, she'll feel more secure and she won't attack. So what I've got here is our cat camper, right? So what cat I want camper. You to do, you, a little portable tent, and I want you to put it up in the middle of the floor there and have people come over here. But can she relax in that space? I believe that once her energy is played out and she owns more space, she won't feel insecure and attack. Tell me, guys, have there been any attacks since I was here last?
Zero attacks.
Yeah! Give me some. Nothing. Look at it. I've got like the Texas-sized smile.
Before, I was afraid. I knew she was gonna bite me. But now, I don't have any fear of that. I don't think that she's gonna do that to me anymore.
When I first met Simone, she was vicious, and she violently lashed out at me. Now, if I can see Simone take the middle of the room, play with toys, hopefully even let me pet her, my work here is done. It's kind of cool. Having her this close, the first time I met this cat, let me tell you something, she was pretty scary. And now for me to be able to pet her the way I am, I mean, it's a pretty huge transformation.
Remarkable.
Leaps and bounds.
Yeah.
And you guys just look happier.
Now I think we're back at the point where we can start entertaining our friends and family more. We would definitely have to lock her up before. Don't believe I have to do that ever again.
It's a beautiful thing to teach an old cat new tricks, right?